for our Friday Fire Cypher.
It's Friday.
On Sway in the Morning.
Yeah, this the true serum, Heather B.
X only.
This the true serum right here. This the litmus test right here. That's why we do the Fire Friday Cypher.
Big up to Fred the Godson, just because.
My man. Yeah, Fred the Godson, name is a verb, kid.
That's it.
It's equivalent to action. Understand me? You can't hide behind those streams. I don't care if you got a billion streams. That don't mean you can rap. Damn. Give a fuck about your crew and all the danger they done caused. That can't help you when you get behind these mics. Don't mean you can rap. I know you got a big chain, sir. But that chain don't equate to bars, Heather B. That don't mean you can fucking rap.
F-O, facts only.
What you gonna say to Heather B?
Nothing. Don't even talk to me today. It's Friday and I'm geeked.
You understand me?
Liquidation.
What you gonna say to me? Exactly. Nothing. Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5.
Don't talk to me on a Friday.
Welcome to the Valley of the Hyenas.
Hyenas!
Oh, we got some snipers in here today, Heather.
I want to be a part of it, all of it.
Man, we got some snipers. And it was like, okay, we got snipers. Kelly, we're going to need somebody who's making sniper beats. She said, what you looking for? I said, somebody to the tune of that maybe he made some hit records, you know, like Broccoli for Drum. You know, back in the day, multi-platinum songs, Grammy nominated. Somebody who maybe worked with Miguel or, you know, maybe got some diversity to his talent. Maybe he's worked with Calvin Harris or Halsey or G-Eazy or Khalid or Ollie Kendrick Lamar or BB Rexha, Dr. Dre. I mean, we need somebody who can make hits. And I asked this young man to come up here, and he came. Latest hit he been making that people been getting sick off of. It's the one Sicko Mode that he did with Travis Scott. Other writers on that, but that man is here today, ladies and gentlemen. The one and only Roger Shahayib. Did I say it correctly?
That was good. You got it. Yeah.
Got it.
No, how you really say it? It's okay because you said it was good. You didn't say he said it right.
It's Roger Shahayib, but it's close enough.
Shahayib.
Yeah.
All right.
It's a double thing. Yeah. It's a French and Arabic. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It takes time.
You know, I mean, I'm bilingual. I can do this. How long you been making beats? When people look at you, they probably go, "You made Sicko Mode?" Right? How long you been doing music?
Well, I've been playing piano since I was 7 years old, so it's been like 24 years of playing piano and keys. Uh-huh. But I've been making beats for the last like 8 years.
For the last 8 years. Yeah. What song was that turning point in your career that you did? Which artist?
I feel like it was probably Broccoli was the one that like really like set it off, you know, and made an impact, so.
Broccoli was so huge for Drum and eating off that broccoli. Drum's the homie, talented guy. We discovered about Drum that he was, you know, that to do, you know, his musical talents go just beyond rap. You know, he's a singer, he's a musician. Mm-hmm.
He's a musician, producer, singer. He's you know, he's a legend all around. He's got every kind of skill set that, you know, out there.
When you connect with artists like Travis Scott, how does that work? Do you walk up to him and say, "Hey, man, I got beats," or how did that happen?
Well, basically, I met Travis once through Hit Boy. We worked together, but that one time that we worked wasn't when we made Sicko Mode. We were just working that day. But basically, the background is that me and Hit Boy were working in the studio, just kind of making ideas one day, and I had come up with the organ sound that you hear in the beginning of Sicko Mode, the first beat. So, exactly. That's
this
it.
You right here?
Yeah, that's me.
It's Rosé right here. Okay. That's you right there?
That's me.
Astro. Yeah. Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him.
I tried to show him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I tried to show him.
We tried to show him, Heather B.
Yeah.
I'm just going down. I want people to get understanding who we got here.
Mm-hmm.
Miguel, how did that come about?
Well, I actually had been working with one of Miguel's main producers, Happy Perez, mm-hmm. and that's the homie. And basically, we were just making a bunch of ideas, and something we had made about a year before Skywalker came out. He hit me the next year and was like, "Yo, you know, something we did is gonna be a single for Miguel." And I think Travis Scott's gonna be on it as well. But you know, me and Miguel know each other pretty well, and we worked together a few times. So he's a good dude and an amazing producer as mm-hmm. well.
Kendrick Lamar, Dr. Dre.
Yes, I used to work for Dre actually in 2014. I was over at Aftermath.
what I'm trying to do here while he talk, I'm looking at the hyenas that's in the room, just so that you know. I'm doing this on purpose. You know that, right? I'm doing this on purpose right here. Calvin Harris, easily one of the most successful EDM producers in the world in recent years. Were you friends? How did you? And EDM is a whole nother genre in itself.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Well, the Calvin thing happened because Drum hit me up one day and was like, "Hey, Roger, I got a session with Calvin Harris. You want to come do it with me?" And I was like, "Yeah, of course, sure." Because, you know, Drum's a great friend. He brought me into a lot of amazing sessions and introduced me to a lot of other great artists and producers. So I just said, why not? I didn't know what was going to happen, but we just walked in there. And Calvin had one half of that that Cash Out song. Mm-hmm. The first part of it was kind of already done, but then he had this drum loop at the end. He's like, "I don't really got anything for this next section." So, you know, I pulled up my keys, came up with some chords, Drum wrote to it, just the classic way that we work, and then mm-hmm. the rest of Cash Out came about that way.
There's a difference between somebody who programs beats and somebody who produces songs. Okay, can you explain that difference from your perspective?
Yeah, well, I mean, I feel like everybody in music, you know, has a specialty, has like a superpower kind of. So for me, you know, I come from the background of, you know, I'm classically trained pianist, but I also, you know, study jazz and R&B and all the other styles as well. So for me, you know, I see just as much importance in being able to come up with chord progressions and sounds that inspire artists and people, you know, to come up with crazy stuff, and just as much as the beat is as influential. So I think both work hand in hand to, you know, make an amazing song, an amazing, you know, platform for the artists to express themselves on.
Okay.
So many like up and coming MCs and producers watch this show for this purpose, to see what the Friar Friday Cypher is all about. But you know, in the back of your mind, sometimes you don't get support from your family. So I just want to know like your background, and was your family supportive of you just like, you know what, I'm just going to be producer. I want to do music. I want to fall into music. Because you don't always get that support.
That's funny that you bring that up, because you know, my dad, he's, you know, he was strict with me. He was always very you know, had the dream of me becoming, you know, a classical pianist and everything. And as soon mm-hmm. as, you know, when I graduated college, he wanted me to kind of keep going and get my master's degree in piano and become like a professor and concert pianist. But deep down, like, you know, I just wanted to make hits. I just wanted to, you know, collaborate with collaborate.
Yeah, fuck the opera. You wasn't doing that.
No, I mean that's my roots deep down. But you know, like I started working with a lot of artists. I started doing a lot of shows. I had like, I was in like hip hop bands and stuff like that, and I was doing a lot. And my dad was like, you know, like, you got a degree in classical music, like, you know, why are you trying to, you know, do producing and hip hop and stuff? Like, he just didn't get it. Mm-hmm. But then, you know, a few years down the line, once he started seeing, you know, like Broccoli came out, and then he called me one day and was like, "Hey, like, I had a customer walk in my store and he was playing Broccoli, and I told him my son produced." So then he started, once he started,
dad got on it after that.
No. Caught the vapors.
No. Give him the gas face, dad. I tried to tell you that. Tell your dad you work with Bruno Mars. He'll get it then.
Oh yeah, no, they're aware. I've every time some crazy stuff happened, I would call and be like, "Yo, I just worked with, you know, so and so tonight, or I just met," and they're just like, "Oh, cool," you know.
Mm-hmm. ASAP Ferg, ASAP Rocky, Bruno Mars, Big Crit. Mm-hmm. I mean, the names go on and on and on. That's who we got in our Fire Friday Cypher. Rosé, Shahayat. Damn it, God.
No, it's good.
Okay, Shahayat. Right?
That was it.
Shahayat.
That's it.
Shahayat.
That's
damn
the one.
Shahayat.
Yeah.
Shahayat.
So what would you say then?
It's my new beat tag.
What would you say then to the up-and-coming producer or artist who's sort of getting some non-support from their family? You know, what would you say to them, you know, because you were sort of in that position? How would you encourage them?
I mean, honestly, like, nothing in life is easy. No profession, whether you want to be a doctor, a lawyer, or an artist, or whatever it is, it's like, you know, even if you have the support from your parents to be like, you know, like a professor or a doctor or whatever, you still got to go through the hardship of the education part. So either way, it's like, you know, you kind of got to break through and prove them wrong. And that's the whole thing that you got to do is, you know, obviously, you know, every parent's concern is, I always hear the same thing, like, make sure you're getting paid. Are you getting paid? Are you getting money? And it's just like, it's coming, you know, it's hard to explain that to them, to be like,
yeah,
like, you know, it takes like a few years sometimes, but I'm going to get the money or whatever. And it's like, you know, my dad was never, you know, impressed until, like, you know, things started showing up. But that's not what's important. What's important is that, you know, you make a name for yourself, you find your sound, and obviously, you know, keeping good relationships with people and having a good reputation is everything. So I feel like just keep pushing through and, you know, use the, from your parents, when your parents are against you, just use that as fuel to, like, break through and prove them wrong one day, and then they'll support you. So,
thanks for sharing. Yeah, that's real shit.
Yeah. Rojae Shahayat.
That's it.
Sway of the Morning. Will this intro ever be made into a song?
You know what? The crazy story is, there is a whole... The whole story is, me and Hit-Boy made this track together, and it was actually a song with Travis and Drake just on its own, and... That's what it was perceived to be at first, and then once Astroworld came out, they cut it off on the first minute, and then, you know, they don't give you the rest of it. So who knows if one day the whole version of it will come out.
Well, if you got it on your laptop, it could come out today. Sway in the Morning, Fire Friday Cypher.
Hashtag that hoe, no love.